my current job portfolio, which is House and Hill, I get to straddle two different worlds. One, which is the traditional world, where I deal with artisans and things like fast courier or timelines or quality control. It's almost Greek to them. On the other hand, I have New Age, where I have to create a 360-degree experiential brand, which should deal with the love of time to hand. So you are seeing changes happening, but they are vastly different in both the worlds. But I also find that people need to reach out to all the government funds that are being created. The government is doing stuff to encourage women entrepreneurs. There's a fantastic tax haven that they have created, which is 3 years that you don't need to pay tax if you are a woman entrepreneur. Corporates are changing their policies. They are the maternity leave, the sabbaticals that they take, they're creating pressures. So NGOs are reaching out, creating funds, and trying to encourage women to work. We are far from being able to have, you know, to say that yes, women empowerment is happening across cities. But today, 10% of the workforce of entrepreneurs are women. S&P report, the index says that S&P 500 index says that we are the women. There are 14.2% women in corporates. All of these are significantly higher than what it was. So you are seeing the change happening. And I believe that that's encouraging.
Very good. Now it sounds like the right steps are in place.
I have an equal relationship in my marriage. And I hope to be able to create a similar scenario for my daughter. But I see this happening around us, and you see it at every single level. It could be a friend, it could be your mate, it could be various people who will not, in India, make a decision without asking their male counterpart. However, I would like to know, in this room, which are the women, if you can just put up your hand, who have, after marriage, taken your husband's name? I'd like to also now ask the women who have kept their maiden name and taken their husband's name. Or the single women who are about to do that. And that's what this is what I'm talking about. Times are changing. Times are changing, and the entire mindset is changing. So slowly but surely we're getting there. The number of women that we have in Parliament today is far greater than we had a few years back. In 1995, in 1970, we had no global CEO which was a woman in any Fortune 500 company. Today, we have 26. So it's changing. It's not changing in the patriarchal world, but it would be myopic of me to say that we don't live it. It is the truth. But like Nancy said, be the change you want to see.
And I think one of the great starting points is what you mentioned about having more women in power. So hopefully then we'll have more regulations about getting certain percentage of women on boards, corporate boards, and little by little. I'm also raising two small daughters, and so I also like to see the differences when I was younger and how they're being raised.